Good afternoon, everyone. Tatring tambuti ini cikakasi cikke nang cik suna samsung. Trendil cikjor nang miki ini jubat sumji kendo banam batangan. Entah nang ying ki kundo nang batangwala ini samtu tashi delengka. Tu cek sih, entah dalam tak di rolling di ngaji dia tu skotishun itu yang tangguh cakap juga le, dengan di cium itu ni di tangguh sikit cakap juga, mara ngaran so ini cik nangbi ke lomba mana awak mahu cik la, dengan di tu skotishun itu susun barai. Tetapi pada masa yang orang tu berjuang nanti yang nalu ni ina yang ini canggung orang berjuang juga kecok kantelak saja kawan ina yang ini culung mandawa mampu jatuh ruru jenang lapar tu orang tu cip nampas anje begi tak jumpa mandawa tu jatuh ruru jene doling ciate kecik berjuang jatuh jene itu senangi yare tetapi di itu ceng orang tu sani endele yungin ke cetang nampas jatuh bule di nalu ni yang ini cip kiri Nampaknya guna tanah yang ini dari mampu insan ini tidak sedikit kodik sih, tidak cewa ina ini cik ya bujuk caya kerjaan di cijamne tu sesi beri ini cedang tak ko cik cuci drone sing ini cacing buta lu ini mixi ke cik orang tu tingsan ke beri niatan lapau ke tu kam dila yang cik culu mandawa lapar tu tak nampak yang ini jari ina yang retina yang cik serlangkat itu. Tuk sesuatu ruk je, tumbuh je, dan doling je. Ini cik-cik lo coba zaman orang tu bebe ni tu, ini yang mahal lah, ya lah. Cik tap dewa tang, ini tinggi kita kodan tu ya le leh lau. Tinggi kita jumsi mampu cik tinggi tuk masuk kodan syurga tinggi. Nampak lagi tuk sesuatu tinggi 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 ni dia pernah dila ni tu je syurga ini. Tinggi kita mampu syurga ya skim tu. So now we'll try to say some word in English. Today, on this extraordinary occasion of a dialogue of three major traditions of Buddhism, it is my honor and privilege to welcome venerable spiritual masters from Theravada tradition, Mahayana, Zen, and Vajrayana tradition. And I would also like to welcome Honorable Peginash, a member of parliament for Parkdale High Park, and distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, to this great event. I believe that this kind of dialogue can make a great contribution to today's world. The wisdom and realization of the Buddha can make this world better and safer, and make all the beings who live within it happier and more compassionate, particularly human beings, because the message that Lord Buddha delivered to us 2500 years ago is the method to build, how to build genuine happiness, which we all wish to have, and which we all have the potential. In other words, it is a method to develop basic good nature that is in every one of us. This is not just beneficial for Buddhist practitioners, but this is a teaching that can benefit all the sentient beings, regardless of what realm they were born in, and what religious they belong to, and what nationality they are. Just as the sun rises in the sky without any discrimination. So this is a century when human beings are experiencing great development in terms of external material that considered to be the key to happiness. And through this emphasis on consumerism, human beings are falling into more and more suffering, such as depression, anxiety, fears, and lack of contentment. Although we are living in a time and place where the development of external material is incredibly high, that we have managed to build aeroplanes that we can travel thousands of miles an hour, and we managed to build all those electronic things that make, that we can talk from one side of the earth to other side as we are sitting together. And also we are educated in many different directions. We even can tell how many planets in this universe, and also we can tell how many cells in every single body. And we managed to build weapons that can destroy the whole world in a second, but we haven't managed to protect this earth, and also we haven't managed to remove our own anger and hatred and jealousy. The teaching that Lord Buddha has taught, such as the Four Noble Truths, Eight Four Noble Paths, and Six Perfections, compassion and loving kindness, are the method to overcome and transform our negative emotions, which are the cause of all the suffering of sentient beings. Even many of the problems that we have developed in the last several decades, such as the war and terrorism, incurable disease, and natural disasters often created by human beings out of their negative emotions, such as anger, hatred, jealousy, pride, and ignorance. In this respect, I believe that Buddhist practitioners have a great responsibility to preserve the teachings of Buddha. The monastic communities have even bigger responsibilities to expand the teachings of the Buddha, not only within the monasteries and our own community, but also larger area of the world. Emphasizing on environmental protection, saving lives on this planet, and building peace and harmony between the nations and the communities and family members, which are the key element of the Buddha's teaching. In order to do that, I thought this was important to get together all the masters of the different traditions to share their views and ethics and experiences. I realized that this is a great opportunity to have many masters from so many traditions of Buddhism to get together at the same time and same place, which is actually not so easy. We're also extremely fortunate to live in a country that gives full freedom to accept all the religion and spiritual activities. Canada is a country that permits the practice of all the religion and culture and tradition. So it also gives full support and encouragement to study and practice on whatever spiritual tradition or religion that you belongs to. Because of that reason, not only as a Buddhist, but as a citizen of this great nation, we have responsibility to make contributions to promoting peace and happiness. We have a great responsibility to pass messages of compassion and loving kindness and wisdom that we have learned from Lord Buddha to future generations of this great nation. And our guests here today came from many different backgrounds of Buddhist traditions, used different techniques, strategies, and mechanisms which provide different approaches to study and practice of Buddhism, which appeal to different human dispositions. Ultimately, we all have same goal, and by introducing sincerity, honesty, loyalty, and trust, we can hope to build a world of peace for people of today and future generations. Thank you again for joining this landmark event. Thank you very much. Thank you, everyone.